This holy man fought to the death for the law of his God. He did not fear the words of the godless, for he was built on a solid rock. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today, the church celebrates St. Boniface, who's called the Apostle or Patron of Germany. He was a martyr of faith. May the martyr St. Boniface be our advocate, O Lord, that we may firmly hold the faith he taught with his lips and seal with his blood, and confidently profess it by our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
You have followed my teaching, way of life, purpose, faith, patience, love, endurance, persecutions, and sufferings, such as happened to me in Antioch, Iconium, and Lystra. Persecutions that I endured. Yet from all these things the Lord delivered me. In fact, all who want to live religiously will be persecuted, but wicked people and charlatans will go from bad to worse, deceivers and deceived. But you remain faithful to what you have learned and believed, because you know from whom you learned it, that from infancy you have known the sacred scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All Scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for refutation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent, equipped for every good work. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. O Lord, grant peace to them who love your law. Though my persecutors and my foes are many, I turn not away from your decrees. O Lord, grant peace to them who love your law. Permanence is your word's chief trait. Each of your just ordinances is everlasting. O Lord, grant peace to them who love your law. Princes persecute me without cause, but my heart stands in awe of your word. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. Those who love your law have great peace, for them there is no sun but law. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. I wait for your salvation, O Lord, and your commands I fulfill. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. I keep your precepts and your decrees, for all my ways are before you. O Lord, great peace have they who love your law. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
As Jesus was teaching in the temple area, he said, "How do the scribes claim that Christ is the Son of David? David himself, inspired by the Holy Spirit, said, 'The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I place your enemies under your feet.' and writing a letter to a younger person, or maybe somebody who needs words of encouragement. So one of our challenges that we can do is to think of somebody in your own life who may need some encouragement today, or this week, or this weekend. And could you send them a little letter? It doesn't have to be 5 or 6 chapters of St. Paul to Timothy, but it could be one little letter of reaching out, and it could be from your first letter of Joe to Roger, or your first letter of Heather to Susan, whatever it might be, maybe to one of your kids or grandkids. Just giving them encouragement during these times. This is a tough time, and you know, it's the world right now, and people are dealing with it in all sorts of certain ways, and we are too. But we could be instruments of encouragement to reach out to other people. Hey, I'm thinking of you. I'm praying for you. I'd like to hear from you. How are you being involved with what's happening in the world? And then I'm going to be a person that listens. I want to be a person of encouragement, but I also want to be a person that listens to others. And that way, you know, we can, our hearts can be open to what they are experiencing, and then our hearts are always open to the Lord. So, St. Boniface, give us the courage. St. Paul, help us to accompany others by encouraging. Let us now turn to our Father with confidence as we present our prayers and petition. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, all of our church leaders, may they be filled with the knowledge of God's will, with all spiritual wisdom and understanding, and leading us to do what is right. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may grant all nations, all of our leaders, prudence and compassion, that prudence and compassion for all who strive to work together for the good of all, especially the most vulnerable among us, those who are poor, the unborn, and the elderly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for the end of all racial injustices, that we may look at others as made in the image and likeness of God always. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a young men and women seeking their vocation in life, may they respond to the Lord's call with courage. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they share the gift of God's eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Sacrament and Mass intention is offered for James B. Wire. For the prayers that we have in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, send your Holy Spirit now upon your church and each one of us here today in our world. Give us the courage to do what is right. We ask these things in Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread and the offering, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and to become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, in my sacrifice to yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Sanctify our offerings by your blessing, O Lord, we pray, and by your grace may we be set on fire with that flame of your love, through which St. Boniface overcame every bodily torment through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr, St. Boniface, pour out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, on the feeble bestow strength to bear your witness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord our God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are the holy, O Lord, God of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood. The blood of the new and eternal covenant should be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. Save us,
Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you and call us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Lawrence, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints that have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. At the Savior's command, and full by the high teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit. take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but for the sake of the Lord, my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
may the sacred mystery